Welcome, Grade 12s, to the second and final video, or third and final video, of quality of performance. So we've discussed quality in the previous two videos, the impact that good quality has on a business, and now we're gonna focus this whole video on total quality management. Okay, so this is all about the systems, the processes. How do you ensure that there's a good quality product or service that goes to the customer consistently? You don't want to have a knit one, slip one, and then people start talking, and then you lose out on the market share. You want to have a constant good flow of products or services, and you want to ensure that their quality is ensured. So what do you need to understand at the end of this lesson? You need to be able to elaborate on the meaning of what is TQM, total quality management. You need to identify the elements from scenarios, the skills development or continuous skills development, quality of client and customer satisfaction, continued improvement to processes and systems, adequate financing and monitoring and evaluation of quality processes. Okay, so they'll give you a scenario. You need to, from the scenario, by understanding the work, be able to identify the different elements. Okay, then you need to discuss or analyze or evaluate the impact of these elements on a large business, and how can businesses apply the PDCA model, plan, do, act model. We'll get to that at the end. Using that to improve the quality of the products. Then we'll explain the role or importance of quality circles, which is important. Explain or discuss the impact of total quality management if it is poorly implemented by businesses. So what happens if you don't do it? And recommendations on how total quality management can reduce the cost of quality. That's the one of the goals as well with TQM, to give a good customer service, which will lead to good marketing, good PR, but in the end to reduce your quality cost, because that is sky high. Right, so what is the meaning of total quality management? Total quality management, and for just for your reference, I'm using the abbreviation TQM from now on. Okay, so it's an integrated system that is applied throughout the organization. This is what you need to be able to say. It's an integrated system. That means it's a system. Now, what is a system? It's when you do something 3 or 4 or 5 times, the same thing over and over and over again. You need to have a system, a template, something that will make it easier. So let me give you an example. If I have to write the email to a customer, and I write it once, then I personalize it, I do it this way, and each email requires attention of different detail. Alright, but if I have an introduction email that I want to send out to a lot of prospective clients, then I can say a lot of generic things with the same thing. I can just change the name, so I can create a template. Okay, which means I don't have to retype the whole thing every time that I'm sending an email to a prospective client. I can just copy paste my template, send it, and change the name. Okay, that's a system. That means I'm doing something, creating a system or a process which will make my life easier, which I say the same thing. I'm consistent, again the word consistent, and I want to save time and money. Okay, so this is a system. And where is it applied? Throughout the whole organization. And this helps to design or produce or provide good quality products or services to customers. This is your end goal. You want to have something that you constantly provide the same thing to customers, and you want to do it the quickest, the fastest, and with the least cost. It's a thought revolution in management, where the entire business is operated with customer orientation in all the business activities. In the previous video, we showed you the business functions and how quality is important in each function. Okay, so this is where it changed for management. They said, okay, if we want to sell a good quality product, that must be reflected in all the business environments. If our quality is not reflected in each department, that means our product is not of utmost good quality. Okay, so they went back and said in each step where we manufacture something, it must be of the same quality. Why? If I, let's say we take a glass of Oros, okay, your end goal is you want to give the consumer a full 2-liter bottle of Oros concentrate, but you have to fill it systematically at each point. So let's say I'm making a car, but the way you make your car is by, if you're pouring either Oros into this Oros concentrate 2-liter bottle, or are you pouring water in, okay, because you're still doing the job, same job, but it depends on the quality. So if the same quality is upheld, then at the end of the production line, your car, if we look at the visual presentation, you'll have a 2-liter filled with Oros concentrate. You'll have that rich, thick orange color. You'll have the smell, you'll have the texture of Oros, and your customer will have his concentrate. But if you filled it with the water, you'll have your 2-liter of Oros in the same bottle, but they will see it's diluted. They will see it's not the right quality. So your car will be a car, but it doesn't have the right parts, the right specifications, the wrong wheels. Can you see what I'm saying? So quality is important. This is now where the management start and say it must be in every process, and why it's with the customer in mind. This enables businesses to continuously improve on the delivery of products to satisfy the needs. If you have quality processes at each and every station, it is almost impossible to make a mistake. I want you to think quickly when you put in petrol. Have you ever thought of why it's that's quite interesting. Why do they use that design when they put in petrol or diesel? Have you ever noticed that it's different colors on petrol, diesel, different sizes? It was a design that was that came from Japan, I think. It's I'll double check on that, but it's they call it pokeyoki. Okay, that means only one specific thing will fit into this gap. All right, it's like a piece of a puzzle. Okay, only one piece can fit there. So that's what they want to make, we want to use each process for. They want to make sure that you can only follow that specific way. Why? If you do it that way, you'll get the same quality. How do you get the same quality? You do the same thing every time. That's consistency. That's quality. Okay, doesn't it help if you do the same mistake every time? That's just stupid. But if you do the same thing, if you want good quality and you do the same quality work every time, that means you'll get consistent results. Does it make sense? Just on the example of the petrol or diesel, if I'm not training my employee all the time and explaining to him where is what, I still need to do that on a basis, and part of that is by color coding everything so that he can visually, or she can visually see, okay, this petrol and this is diesel, and this fits into this car. But if I open a petrol tank, right, that's the theory of pokeyoki, it's almost impossible to fit in a diesel into a fuel cars when you put in the petrol. Okay, so it will immediately, alarm bells will go off, and the guy will see, oh wow, I almost made a mistake here. All right, so it's that thing that you cannot make a mistake. Okay, that's the idea behind it. Now, I know a lot of designs have changed in the meantime, so a lot of petrol stations don't have the different sizes, but this is where it was actually originated. Right, management ensures that each employee is responsible for the quality of his or work or actions. Okay, how do they do that? Each station have to deliver a specific quality, and the only way you get quality is if you are held accountable. That's also where there's performance bonuses that comes in. TQM focuses on achieving customer satisfaction, and it looks for continuous improvement in all the businesses, processes, products, and services. And TQM takes steps to ensure the full involvement and cooperation of all employees in improving quality. Right. So, look at the elements. We're going to look at continuous improvement to processes and system. Going to look at continuous skills development or education and training for the employees. It's all about the client or customer satisfaction. Do we have adequate financing, and do we have the capacity to continue what we're doing? And lastly, the monitoring and evaluation of these processes. So how do we monitor it? How do we evaluate it? So let's start. So what's the impact of total quality management elements on a large business? So the first element is continuous improvement processes. Okay, so what's when they say impact, they want you to say either advantages or disadvantages, or positives or negatives. Okay, so the positives: large businesses have more resources, okay, to check on quality performance. That means they've got a lot of employees. There's a lot of people that they can use to make sure that the quality is up to certain standards. Small businesses, if you want to have quality checks at each and every stop, you'll have to employ more people, and it's not always viable for them to do so. But with large companies, you've got more resources, more people to check on the quality for. If large companies got enough capital resources available, so to them it's more a necessity than small companies. They have to do it. Why? There's more processes to check. If you're a small company and you only have 5 people, that means you probably only have 5 processes to check, which means you as a manager can do that. But if you run a company with hundreds of processes to check, it's impossible for you to ensure that all the quality is done. So you'll have to have a manager that's responsible for 10 or 20. Okay. Large businesses have a person dedicated to improvement. Okay. So in logistics, we find that specifically. There's industrial engineers, and they focus specifically on processes. They want to ensure that the process is the leanest. That means the shortest distance, the raw materials is the closest. There's no double touching the product, because they believe the more you touch it, the more you can damage it, the more chance there is of the quality of the product that's going down. So you don't want to touch it too much. Plus, every time a person touches it, there's actually a cost involved. But that's going into too much detail. So that's they've got people dedicated. They're willing to take risks or try new processes and systems, because they're able to absorb the impact of losing money. So to them, appointing another person to check on quality is not the end of the world. They can absorb it. They can afford to use the services of quality circles. Negatives: large-scale manufacturing will complicate it. Why? You have to understand, you have to have the best people to operate the machines to understand the quality output. If you have just normal guys that's not trained, this is why training is important, we'll get there. But if you don't, if they don't understand the specialized processes, you're in trouble. Okay, systems and processes take time and effort to implement. So it's also, you have to sign it, get a sign off by the top management. And that sometimes takes a lot of time as well. So that's part, the risk of changing parts of the businesses that are actually working well. So here's the thing with quality. When you look at it, there's a risk of when you get to parts that you see, you know, we should change it. But that has been a part that has been working well and delivering good results. But change is not always bad. So maybe that's a good thing. But when something works, don't change it too much. Okay. Not all negative feedback from employees and customers are going to be accurate, and that may result in incorrect changes or systems and processes. So sometimes customers are just mad, and in a moment they give feedback, and if you react on every single bit, you will change your business model and close your doors. So impact, the feedback from customers must be critically evaluated. Is it true? Is it not? Can I do something or not? All right, next one: impact of continuous skills training or education and training on big businesses. The positives: large businesses have a human resources department, and that's dedicated to skills and training. So there's a dedicated team that's out there to make sure that everyone's skills are up there. Human resource experts ensure that training programs are relevant to increase customer satisfaction. Okay, they have the ability to afford specialized employees. Why? They need them, as I said. In certain processes, you cannot have someone that don't understand a process. So let's say in logistics, you can't appoint a civil engineer if you want to change your processes. He will understand how to build something, but not necessarily how to make your process more lean. Okay, so you need to understand the difference there and appoint their skilled employees, and that's why you need an HR department. Large businesses could conduct skills audits to see how their staff are performing and where they should do training. And it may be able to hire qualified trainers to train employees on a regular basis. Now, they've got a budget, they've got that, and they can hire these trainers to come in on a regular basis. Why? The more you train, the better the chances are that they can understand it. The disadvantages: poor communication can prevent effective training. Okay, it does not help you want to train people, but there's no communication about it. There's a if it's not sent timely or with the right information, or if it's sent in the wrong, even just a bad worded email can put people off, put them in a mood of, oh, you know what, I'm already behind schedule and I have to listen to this guy come speak, that's a big influence on big companies. Okay, so your communication must be up to scratch. Trained employees may leave for better jobs. That's also a positive or a possibility. If you train them too well, and they will be headhunted for other companies. But this is now where it comes in. If you treat them well, they will stay. Loyalty is a good is a big thing these days. But if you don't treat them well, you will lose them. It will demotivate employees if they don't get recognition for training. Okay. Employees who specialize in highly specified jobs may become frustrated or demotivated. Employees may not be aware of the level of competency that should meet they should meet in order to achieve their targets. This is all communication. Can you see that? So it's all about how you handle your employees and what's their level of training. Are they competent? Do they need training? How are you going to communicate it? How are you going to up? Why? What's the end goal? Happy customers. How do you do that? Make sure you give a good quality product. How do you ensure that? Do that on a consistent basis. How do you do that? Make sure that it's there on each and every process and give training to everyone that's touching the product. Okay. Total or client satisfaction on a large business. Large businesses uses market research to see how the customers' needs and wants are satisfied. They can promote a positive company image by spending money or by launching as projects or getting articles. They can achieve a state of total customer satisfaction. And they can strive to understand and fulfill customers' expectations by aligning the cross-functional teams across critical processes. I'm not going to explain each one of these lines. It's self-explanatory. You can just read through of them, And again, like I said, I don't think it's you don't need to study more than about six or so. Okay. May lead to higher customer retention, loyalty, as we said. And it lead to increased competitiveness. That's what you want. You want to be more profitable, take more market share. That means you are competing. Okay, that's what happens if your clients are happy. So think about it in this way. Happy clients means they will return. Happy clients will continue to buy from you. So you can conduct market research to when you have promotional days or PR days. Whatever that means, just how will that influence your customers? Okay. Negatives. Employees who seldom come into contact with customers do not have a clear idea. Right? So you can sell something, but because there's no direct link, it's difficult to gauge where your customer satisfaction is. That's why a lot of companies have got salespeople and they follow customers' relationship CRM systems. Where they have to actively engage with the client at least once a week to make sure the client is happy. If there's problems, they can highlight and fix it. Okay, monopolistic companies have an increased bargaining power, so they don't necessarily have to please customers. All right, not all employees may be involved or committed to the satisfaction of the client. So you, that's why you have to do training. You have to ensure that everyone's on the same page. Okay. Impact of adequate financing and capacity on large businesses. Large businesses have sufficient financing, okay, that they've got money. They can afford to put systems in place. they are able to afford product research or market research, they can afford to purchase quality raw materials. Disadvantages: if the demand of the company's product increases and orders coming in quicker, but they don't have the capital to fund the production, then they sit with a backlog and not good customer satisfaction index. Again, if you can't service them, give them the quality they want, then they will not follow you, adhere to you. These rapidly growing companies can consume large amounts of capital as they try to balance normal operations and expansion. Okay, impacting of monitoring and evaluating quality processes. It prevents product defects and minimizes wastage. So this is now, we've done everything, we've implemented it. Now, how do you monitor and evaluate your processes? If you do it correctly, what's the benefits? You will prevent your product defects and minimize the wastage or your customer complaint. Okay, that just means if the processes are of good quality and so robust, that means there is no defects. That means less cost. Okay, minimum wastage. Good quality checks or procedures will minimize the replacement, again the cost, breakdown of equipment machinery. You may be equipped to get things done the right the first time. That's super important. It will improve your performance and maintain high quality standards. It can improve your current and future management of quality outputs and provide clear indication about quality aspects. Okay, so there's a lot of advantages to be able to monitor if your systems are working, right? It's like a temperature gauge. But if you're in a big business, it's often divided and compartmented into silos. So that's difficult to get everyone then to communicate, to be part of it. It takes longer to detect problems or respond, and it's not viable to check quality of all the products. So let's say you sell more than one product, okay? If you want to check quality, you have to have a lot of attention to detail. Now, some companies do that, others do just spot checks. It all depends on the type of product and if it requires quality checks. So you have to ensure that your system checks for the right things. All right, I'll start with this in the following video that we can go through.